We had hoped that Carol's brother would be here tonight. He was called away out of the country on business, as it turns out, but happy to have in his stead the historian of Olympia Fields Country Club and a guy who was very much behind and happy to see this happen, Mr. Robert Topel. Bob?
Thank you, Tim. My instructions read that we had 5 to 7 minutes. I shall not use them. I got to be good friends with Carol in the last 10 years of her life. And I'm not going to stand up here and tell you about all our accomplishments. You've seen the movies, you've read the plaque. I'll tell you about some of the photos that were up there, however. Carol came to Olympia Fields at about age 12 or 13. And she quickly became an accomplished golfer in the club. In 1956 and 57, she was allowed to play in the Women's Club Championship. That was back in the days when when club championships meant who's the best golfer in the club, not who's a regular member and things like that. She won 2 years in a row, much to the chagrin of the women golfers at Olympia. After that, she won the she won the Western Junior and the CGA Championship. At which point she got her first award like this. The club made her an honorary member for life as a teenager. And so she was always with us. She would be very pleased by this, but I want to tell you how she got into professional golf, and I'll be as brief as I can. Patty Berg asked her, what do you want to do with your life? She said, I want to be a professional golfer. She said, well, do you have a sponsor? She said, no. And she said, Patty said, well, I have to introduce you to your fellow member, Janet Olson. And Janet is the woman you saw in several of the photos up there, the elderly woman. Those photos were taken in the 1970s. And she came to Janet, and Janet said, so Patty says, you want to be a golfer? She said, yeah. Do you need a sponsor? And Carol said, I couldn't talk. I was so nervous. So Janet spoke for me, and Janet said, well, will $600 a month do it? She said, yeah. So she staked her on the tour, as she had already done for Babe Didrikson for the first 2 years of her career. And when Carol came back and said, a few years later, and said, I want to pay you back, Janet said, no, you can't pay me back. You just have to do this for someone else. And she spent the rest of her life trying to accomplish what Janet had hoped for her. So I think somewhere tonight, Janet and Carol are sitting together, smiling with satisfaction. They're all very honored to be part of this. And thank you to the Illinois PGA and to everybody here tonight. Good night.